Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to be showing you a very simple spring tablescape and one that I am going to be using for Easter this year. Even though for Easter this year, it's just going to be my husband, myself, and two kids, I still want to decorate as if I normally would to still make the day very special. So I put together this tablescape last night and I'm really excited to share it with you guys. I'm using a lot of my favorite pieces in here and a lot of textures and bright colors that I think are just perfect for spring in general, but specifically Easter. And I'm also going to be showing you a little tutorial on how I aged this corbel. I'm using two of them in my tablescape, and I originally got them. They were just this natural wood color, and I'll show you the technique I used to make them look more aged. If you enjoy home decor videos and DIYs, make sure you subscribe to my channel and give this one a thumbs up, and let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do is lay out all of our items for our tablescape. The first thing I do whenever I style a space is I lay out items that I think might work in that space. So that's what I did here. I have these two corbels here, which at the end of this video, I will show you how I gave them this aged look. And then I have these moss balls that are from Hobby Lobby. I think they are so perfect for spring. And then over here, these are candlesticks. One of my favorite things to collect for home decor are candlesticks. I think they're so versatile, they're so cozy, and they're just one of my favorite things to especially add to a tablescape. And then this next piece here is from the Hearth and Hand collection at Target. I love using glass pieces. It's just another cozy texture that you can add to a space. This one has room for candles on top, and I love that this glass bottom lets you add in seasonal decor to it. And over here, I always like to add in, if I'm decorating for a specific season, very seasonal appropriate items. So for spring and Easter, I have these eggs that I found at Michael's, and they're all just kind of neutral tone. We have some pinks, whites, greens, blue. They're very just like neutral and muted, which I love. This is a little bit of Easter grass that I found at Walmart. And these flowers are so pretty. I've been incorporating a lot of pink in my spring decor. And these are from Hobby Lobby. These are pieces of wood that I stained myself that I am actually planning to use for shelves whenever I finish my powder room remodel. But for now, I'm going to lay them out on the table and use them to put all of this stuff on as the base of my centerpiece. I love the look of a naked table, which means without like a runner or a tablecloth. But I do think that you need some sort of item to put everything on that will ground it and make it look so it's not just randomly placed on the table, which I will show you when I go ahead and style this.
Life is a winding road, no telling where it goes. Driving through days and nights, won't stop for traffic lights. And I really wanna know, really wanna know, if I'll ever figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down, I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind, I will keep on holding my head high. Even if the sky is falling down, jumping from cliffs so high, trusting our wings to fly. Sometimes we're crashing down, but we get up and start from the ground. And I really wanna know, really wanna know, if I'll ever figure out where the road goes. Even if I'm falling down. I will keep on searching for my highs. You can say I lost my mind. I will keep on holding my head high.
Okay, and now for the corbel tutorial. What you're going to want to do is use some kind of spackle. In my case, I used what was called lightweight joint compound, and I just randomly applied it all over the corbel. And what you're trying to do here is just to achieve texture. So once you have applied this all around your corbel, you want to let it dry for at least 4 hours, but preferably overnight, so it gets really hard and nothing will chip off when you go to paint it. You're also going to need white chalk paint and two types of paint brushes. I used one that was a little larger and stiff. This is where you're gonna apply the majority of the paint. And then one that was a little smaller, and this one is so you can just go in and kind of fine tune any hard to reach places and little details that you wanna add the white paint to.
Even if the sky is falling down, even if the sky is falling down.
I'm using this antiquing wax, which I found at Michael's, but they sell these all over the place. And you're gonna go in with a small paintbrush and you are just going to apply this very lightly with a very loose hand, just because you want to apply it on the ridges and on the corners, just where things are normally aged, and you don't want to go in too harsh with a dark brown color. So as you can see, I'm just applying it around the outside in little crevices, and then I'm going with whatever is left on my paintbrush back to areas that are raised and kind of just wiping off the excess color on there. And that just helps to achieve that aged antique look that we are going for.
A tree, I remember how it started. I was lost in a dream when the fire in my heart said, and opened a